Have you ever Googled something? Have you ever had a friend recommend it to you by Facebook or use that Snapchat filter that gives you puppy ears? Then you've used deep learning. Deep learning, that buzzword you keep on hearing, is simply a program or a network that you can teach by showing it examples. But in order to make those networks perform better, we've had to make them deeper and more complex. And that came at a cost. They require more data, more time, and more expensive equipment. So that's really prevented them from being applied in fields that could benefit from them, fields like medicine or manufacturing. So I thought, why don't we take a step back? Why don't we take a hint from something that's been evolving for millions of years to perfect vision, something low energy, accurate, and efficient? Us. If we can teach our networks to use the same cues that we've evolved to use as part of our visual system, maybe they'd be more likely to give us more relevant results more efficiently. So I focus on four main cues. Spatial cues. Take a look at this optical illusion, for example. You walk by this park, nothing special, just a park. But if you look at it from the right angle, that's when the beauty emerges. And that's the same with computer vision. Sometimes allowing our networks to project into different image spaces can let them see things they previously couldn't. What about depth cues? We see our world in 3D. It's how we get around. And giving our networks the ability to leverage 3D data can allow them to better understand the world around them. Temporal cues. If you just take one frame from this video, you wouldn't know if this guy's throwing the ball or if this guy's catching the ball. But it all makes sense when you see the sequence. And using recurrent neural networks, we can give our algorithms the ability to understand time. Finally, context cues. This kid's not eating ice cream. You inferred that from the blue background. But you've also been using context cues to follow along with my slide this entire time. You see, you lumped concepts and images together based on a common color background they share. Wouldn't it be great if we can give our networks this kind of insight? In autonomous driving, for example, using depth and temporal cues, we can have a Snapchat-like filter that detects pedestrians. What about in medical imaging? Instead of recommending friends, we can have a network that uses spatial and context cues to detect cancer cells in CT scans and recommend treatments instead. And finally, elderly assistance. We face a growing problem of elderly people overpopulating elderly care homes, so much so that in 5 to 10 years, we won't have enough healthcare workers to support them. But what if we empower our elderly and we empower our healthcare workers with a Google-like assistant tailor-made for them? Today is the day that we can solve all of these tomorrow problems and many more. Thank you for your time.